If you're looking to buy a mini mill and already set your eyes on brands like Clutch or Grizzly or Harbor Freight, you notice the pattern here. They're all the same except for the price. And I had one of those mills before and it was okay. What wasn't okay is never-ending issues with alignment of parts and the lack of weight. Oh, and also, there's no belt drive for any of them. But I had that fixed on my other video, so be sure to go check it out. What are we seeing here is another no-name, no-brand milling machine for double the price. And you may be thinking, won't it have exact same issues as before? Well, right out of the box it may not be so obvious at first, so let's see what's what. Manual with part numbers and basic instructions. Basic tools in the box that's impossible to close that you get with all Chinese machines. And immediately a lack of wrench that holds the spindle becomes apparent. I later made myself this ugly but functional wrench from a scrap, but still, I think, since this tool is often used, it should be included. All metal surfaces are coated with some kind of film that's dry to touch. And before I even go any further, I'm already impressed with how little the backlash is on X-axis. I won't bother showing you, but there's actually an adjustment that can bring this backlash down to zero. And I didn't even think this was possible at this price range. Also, I like how this protection glass just moves out of the way instead of being held by a screw. While X and Y controls are pretty normal, the Z axis is weird. This lever here does not move entire head, it only affects the plunger and has 58mm of travel. For more movement, you have to crank the handle at the top. This is a compromise to allow head tilt and preserve the rigidity, which is very important. I don't care much for a head tilt, but I do care about the rigidity, so the solution here is actually very smart. This mechanism also presents challenges with the DRO on the Z-axis, which I'll talk about later, so be sure to stick around. Another thing I like about this mill is that you have two locks on each axis, which contributes to the rigidity, keeping your part locked and solid, and a very good chip protection both on Y and Z, and a drain port for liquid cooling. Another interesting thing I noticed, and don't quote me on this, but I think that the ways were hand scraped. If that's the case, it means that the fitment was done by hand, not just relying on the machine. This explains the tightness and the smoothness of the operation I experienced later. Another great thing about this mill is that it already has a solid belt drive system. In comparing to my old one, this one runs very quiet even at maximum speed.
Check, check, check.
This is not loud at all. This is awesome. This is awesome. Gibbs in this mill have this notch at each end and a large screw at the end of each axis. Those screws keep the Gibbs from sliding around. My old mill had the dent drilled into the Gibbs instead, so this solution is way better. Now let's talk about some dirt, and there is some to take seriously if you plan to buy this machine. First and most importantly, there's an issue with the collet holder, specifically the R8 version. You can see that it does fit the supply chuck no problem, but if you try to use the standard R8 collets, it does not fit because the threads don't match. This is how it's shipped from a factory, and the factory does not produce them in any other way. Seller had already offered me a partial refund, so you either have to make one yourself or pay someone else to do it. Either way, this really sucks. Another problem also confirmed to originate at the factory is the lack of a second thrust bearing on the left side of the handle plate. You can see there's only one, but there should be one on each side. This one is not too expensive to get, but it's something I'd order in advance if I could. Model numbers on the screen for your convenience. The supplied vise is junk, but don't throw it away. It may become useful for lathe operations if you have one. Instead, get a better vise like this. The supplied chuck is also very bad. Here you can see how much it wobbles, so I can't even use it. This makes the problem with inability to use my collets even more significant. So be sure that you have the means to correct the problem if you choose to buy an R8 version of this mill. I don't know if other collet versions have this issue or not, so don't ask. There's a problem with these handles getting in the way when you move Y axes. Oftentimes you don't even notice they get caught and you end up bending them by accident. So be sure you trim the handles to prevent that. As far as the DRO goes, first I install the X axes in the back, but I lost about 30 mm of travel on Y axis, which is bad. The Y axis is already short enough, so I ended up moving it to the front. Lock screw were a little too high, so I had to drill them lower, as you can see here. To my big surprise, it fit really well, but now original lock screw handles won't fit, so I have to make something up. With the X-axis sensor mounted to the front, I get full range of motion on Y-axis, as you can see here. This is really good. Y-axis was a little bit more complicated, but with a few modifications to the brackets, I was able to get it done. Z-axis is another story. I want to attach this sensor to the spindle plunger so I won't have to use the built-in DRO. I could just attach it to the head, but it will have little to no purpose this way because it has a built-in DRO for the plunger. Hopefully I will solve this issue and let you know more about it in my later video, so please subscribe so you won't miss it. And please comment if you have any questions or concerns, or just comment for fun. I'll appreciate it either way. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and if you did, you owe me a like, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.